Hello everyone, Namaskar, Rajkrishna this side. So let's solve one problem from Laplace transform. We can solve this integration using Laplace transform. There might be other methods as well to solve this, but today I am going to discuss the method which will involve Laplace transform. Okay, so let's solve it step by step. So first of all, I will start off from the innermost thing which we can see here, which is this sine t, sine square t. So first focus will be on sine square t, but we don't know any formula for sine square t. Rather, we know Laplace transform of sine a t is a divided by s square plus a square, and we know the other formula in terms of cos a t, which gives us s divided by s square plus a square. But also we know some ideas of trigonometry which says that sine square t is 1 minus cos 2t divided by 2. So if I replace this, this I can write as 1 by 2 minus cos 2t by 2. So let's first start off by finding the Laplace of sine square t. This is same as finding Laplace of 1 minus cos 2t by 2, isn't it? And this is same as finding Laplace of half minus Laplace of cos 2t by 2. And we can take the constant stuffs outside, and this is nothing but Laplace of 1 minus, again half can be taken out, Laplace of cos 2t. So Laplace of 1, also there is a formula or a result, you can say that this is equal to 1 by s. So this gives us 1 by 2 and 1 by s from here minus. Now Laplace of cos a t is s divided by s square plus a square. So this will be half s divided by s square plus 2 square is 4. Fine enough. So this is nothing but half, and you can write 1 by s minus s divided by s square plus 4. What's next? We have solved it till here. Now let's move a step ahead and find the Laplace transform of sine square t divided by t. Okay, sine square t divided by t. So t is divided, then how we move ahead with this? So division by t property, we know if we divide, if we know Laplace of f of t is f bar s, then Laplace of this is nothing but integral s to infinity f bar s ds. Clear? So let's do this. We know this is equivalent to f bar s, whatever we have calculated, and in LHS we had simply got Laplace of sine square t. Now we are going to move a step ahead and find Laplace of sine square t divided by t. So in LHS, whatever is there, integral will come. So integral s to infinity 1 by s minus s divided by s square plus 4. Now we can simplify this. We can break this into two integral. So integral s to infinity 1 by s ds minus s to infinity s divided by s square plus 4 ds. Now if I multiply and divide by 2, so integral of 1 by s is nothing but log s. Okay, so this will be log s from s to infinity minus, if you take denominator as t, that means s square plus 4 s t. So derivative of s square is 2s, so 2s ds will become dt, which is the numerator. So our integral is becoming what after this substitution? It is simply becoming integral of, after this integral we can simply do the integration, and at the end we can plug in that limit value. So if I do integration side where somewhere as, so this will become integral of dt divided by t, which will give us log t. Okay, fine enough. And now we can put back the value of t, so log mod s square plus 4. Okay, and now this value can be put up here. Okay, so minus 1 by 2, this integral after solving came out to be log mod s square plus 4, and now you can apply limit. Why I did this so that you don't need to change the this interval, otherwise you would have changed it to t. Okay, what's next? This is giving, so I have this I can take the common, because both have the limits from s to infinity. So what I am doing is I am writing this as log mod s minus, and half was there with both, I guess. No, just with the other one. Okay, so I can do one thing, log s square plus 4, and I can make power go on this. Okay, and collectively it is going from s to infinity. And why I have done, because log a minus log b, I know log a minus log b is nothing but log a by b. So in the next step I can do one thing, write this as log s divided by s square plus 4 and power half. Fine, going from s to infinity. What as I am doing, because in denominator I have power half, somewhere if possible I can make numerator also similar. So numerator I can write s square, because s square power half is same as s. Okay, divided by s square plus 4 and collective power half, s to infinity. Now if you wish, in the next step you can take this half outside, so it becomes 1 by 4. And now you can make some adjustment so that this infinity problem is not there. So inside the bracket, divide numerator and denominator by s square. So this will become 1, this will become 1, and this will become 4 by s square. From s to infinity, this adjustment is I am doing just for this infinity, is because infinity is there as one of the limits. Now if you put infinity, the upper limit, There is no problem with that because this 4 by s square, 4 by infinity square, that will become in 0. So you are only left with 1 by 1, which is log 1, and minus log 1 divided by 1, this is left. Now this, if you calculate, this will again turn out to be this thing only. S square divided by s square plus 4. Okay, so this is log 1 is 0, so minus sign I am taking out, and this is nothing but log s square divided by s square plus 4. Okay, now if you wish, you can take this minus sign to the power and flip the log. So this is 1 by 4 log s square plus 4 divided by 4, s square. Fine. So, okay. Fine till now. Now what we need? Now we have solved it sin square t by t. Now further, e power minus t and this integral is there. So what we can do, we know how to solve Laplace transform by definition, because we know by definition, it is becoming a bit lengthy problem. By definition, Laplace of ft is given by integral 0 to infinity e power minus st ft dt. This is by definition. So LHS, you are coming by solving this Laplace of sine square t divided by t. Now if I apply definition, so this Laplace can by definition be written as 0 to infinity e power minus st f of t. In place of that, I have sin square t by t and dt I can write, and this Laplace is equal to 1 by 4 log s square plus 4 divided by s. Now what we want in the question, it is given that we want e power minus t to be there. Okay, if you want e power minus t to be there, so put s equals to 1 on both sides. So if you put s equals to 1 on both sides, you are going to get 0 to infinity e power minus t sin square t divided by t dt is equal to 1 by 4 log, if you put s as 1, s square is 1, so 1 plus 4 is 5, 5 divided by 1 is 5, so this is log 5. So this is what we needed. So again, interesting one, just to say, but a lengthy one at the same time, because you know where we started off with. We started with Laplace of sine square t. There also we have to make some adjustment, use some trigonometry. Then we have to use division by t property. Okay, and after doing a lot of mathematics on that, we have to now use definition on both the side. And if you use definition on both the side, the problem is over. So yes, it was lengthy, I can say, but yes, not that difficult as you can see. So that's it from my side for today. We'll see you with some more problem. You can always visit the playlist which I have on Laplace transform for more such practice problem. Thanks again.